Are we back? We're back.
I showed Lisa how to add a glaze. So here's her inspiration. I mean, you don't have to copy it exactly. It could be your person. But she's added some darkness to it. Now we have one more session on this, which will be done next Monday. And we will add the final highlights and the final darkness, and a little bit of drawing is involved with a little tiny fine paintbrush. But here, I mean, look at the depth in there. Lisa, you did a fantastic job. This is extraordinary. I'm so proud of you.
I had a fantastic teacher.
Well, she had to stand up, walk away. You walked over the other side of the gallery. What did I tell you to do?
You said to squint. Walk on the other side of the gallery and squint and find out where the light is.
Anyway, so I'm very, very proud of you, I gotta say. It's hard to stop painting because you look at it like, oh, I could just add a little color there and a little color. But this is her painting, not mine. But she couldn't stop either. Once you get the hang of it, it's like hard to stop. So, but that was oil glaze. It's just a real thin layer. And you gotta see the glaze. See how there's a glare there? If there's too much of a glare, you probably have too much oil. So make sure you dab off those areas where there's too much oil. Anyway, proud of you.
Thank you.
All right, so we're going to let this dry for a week, and then we'll see you next Monday on that one. Now, I also am showing her how to do a glaze on an acrylic painting. Now, everywhere I go, I take photos, and then I bring them back to the gallery, and eventually, if I have time, I paint them. And it helps me keep my memories alive, like where I was, who I was with. It's kind of fun that way. So Lisa's got thousands of photos, and she picked one. Do you have it on your camera?
That wonderful camera that keeps going away. Yeah.
Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a glaze of an acrylic over top. So you can see her. Where is this, Lisa? Where is this?
Oh, where is it literally?
Uh-huh.
It's in your hand. No, it's the whole world is in your hand. It is up on the Blue Ridge.
On the Blue Ridge Mountains. I don't know if you've been up there, but it's really very cool. So this is the underpainting is what you call this. It's not the painting, it's the underpainting. So really, we're going to take put another layer over top. And how we're going to do that is we're going to take some glazing medium. You don't have to use glazing medium. You could just paint over it with whatever you have. Now, I tone everything down. So I don't take it right out of the tube unless I want to take it out of the tube. And I just tone it down because otherwise it doesn't create like reality for me. I just tone it down, whatever it is. Right here we have this color called smalt. Smalt hue.
Do you want that slanted to the glaze?
Whoops!
Dripping down the canvas.
Oh, I see it. Yeah. Well, can't even see that anyway.
I could get them.
All right, this is my handy dandy palette knife, and it's good for scooping. And let's see. Put a little scoop there. Okay, so you can see that's going to be a nice color for the sky, but we're not going to make it that bright. We're going to tone it down a bit. And now here's the thing, is you really don't need hardly any to go in that glaze. All right, so that's nice and brownish gray. Tone it down. Now I keep working on my colors. It might take me 20 minutes to figure out which is the perfect color. But once I get it, then I go ahead and do my brush strokes. All right, so that's a nice grayish blue. Let's see, I'll put that in there. We take this, what's this? Gloppy medium. That's what that is. Mix it all together, and it's super, super thin. Like, you can hardly see how that is a glaze. It's very translucent.
Is that a slow drying glaze?
Slow drying. Yeah, some of those glazes, they're nice because they help the acrylic painting take longer to dry so that you can do some work in the painting. It acrylics dry very quickly. So, yeah, Liquitex, that's what that is. Glazing. Sure. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I've got a piece of acetate one more time over top, and I'm going to ask her to basically glaze over the whole thing. So we're just going to glaze over the whole thing. There we go. All the way down. Glaze over the whole thing.
Even the mountains or just the sky?
Why not? And you know why? Probably to unify the paint. Yeah. You know, just glaze over it. We're not adding any highlights. We're just kind of putting a little
bit. Plus that green is so dark.
Oh, very, very, very dark. Now here's the cool thing about it is that if there's trees in there, I just kind of like dot, 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 dot. I just kind of pull them out and I push them and I pull them out and I push them because those are all trees. Clouds don't go that way. I can actually lift the clouds out. Lift the cloud out before it dries so I have some lights under there. I have some lights there, and I have some lights there. Okay, so I'm trying to pull some of the clouds out. And you can also use a rag to kind of lift some up and decide where you want some of your brighter clouds to be. Another layer on an acrylic painting. All right, so what do you think, Lisa? You're learning anything today?
Oh, yeah. Way too much. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get that blue.
Oh, you'll get the blue.
With Sienna, it makes no sense.
Oh, you'll get it. Anyway, thanks y'all for joining us. I hope you're having a great day. Monday. Yay. All right, bye y'all.